Good morning, everyone. I am Rushali Dhanokar, Assistant Professor, IT Department. In my last video, we learned about some overview concept regarding macro, right? What is macro call? What is macro definition? Then macro expansion. So, hope so you watch that video. Now, in this video, we will learn about the next topic in the second unit, that is loaders, functions, and types of loader. So, this is part one. So let's see what exactly loaders will be work next. So following points are covered in this video, which includes about loaders, functions, types of loaders. So in this video, we will cover about first type, that is compile and go loader, and second type, that is general loader, and their advantages and disadvantages. So let's see one by one. The first point is about loaders. So what is meant by loaders? I already explained in my last video. Loader is one kind of system software, okay, which perform the loading function. Now what is meant by loading? So loading is a process of placing program secondary memory into main memory for execution purpose, right? When you need to save a particular file, for example .c, .c++, so you should save that file into the secondary memory, into the particular location. Right? But when you need to execute that file, when you run that compile and run that file, at that time this file placed into the main memory for the execution purpose. Okay? So loader load file placed into the secondary memory into the main memory for execution purpose. So this is the working of loader. So loader is responsible for initiating the execution of the process. See in this diagram, this is a structure and working of loader. First, this is your source program, okay? Then this is the assembler. Assembler is one kind of translator. They translate source program into the object program, right? Next one is linker. Linker link some additional files, that is additional frameworks, additional libraries to your object program. Next, loader. So linker, the overall executable code sent to the loader for placed this loader or particular place this executable code into the main memory for execution purpose. Okay, so this is the working and structure of the loader. Next, now functions of loader. Actually there are four main functions. First, allocation. Allocation means to allocate memory space to the particular program. This is the first task performed by the loader. Next, linking. Loader link object program code with necessary library function. All the necessary library function, necessary library routines, right? Some additional frameworks, additional files. These all files are linked to your program, object program code. Okay, that is the work of loader. Next task is relocation. Relocation means it change memory address of program. When particular program load from secondary memory to primary memory, so at that time their address will be changed. So this address will be handled by the loader. This is called as relocation concept. Next one is loading. So finally, executable file which contain machine instructions and data, right? Because executable file is a object file, and object file is a machine understandable format, or we can say that is a binary instruction in binary language in 01 format, right? So all the object file, that is machine instructions and data, will be placed physically into the memory for execution purpose. So this all tasks are performed by the loader in sequential format. First allocation, they allocate the memory. Next linking, link some additional extra file to the object program code. Then relocation, then it change memory address to your program. And last, loading. So loading means actual load this file into the physical memory for execution purpose, right? So these are the functions of loaders. So next. Next concept is types of loader. So actually and basically there are total 6 types of loaders will be present, that is compile and go loader, general loader, absolute loader, then a relocating loader, a practical relocating loader, and linking loader. So in this video we will learn about the first two types, that is part 1, that is compile and go loader and general loader. In my next video, that is part 2, I will explain the remaining types of loader. So let's see the first type of loader. See here, this is just one kind of structure. First, that is your high level language source code. Compiler compile this, convert into the object code. Then linker link some library files, then convert it into the executable program, that is object file, and object file load into the memory for execution purpose. So this is the structure, and this structure will be performed in minimum amount of time or within a second, right? Next. So first type of loader is compile and go loader. So compile and go loader is a first loader, or we can say one kind of basic loader, right? Generally, this loader is used in mostly in 1970 purpose, right? For example, in Fortran language, okay? The language which developed in before C or C++ language, right? We know that C or C++ language, that was the basic language. So Fortran language which developed before C or C++ language. So in that language, compile and go loader, this concept will be used, okay? So in compile and go loader, instructions are read line by line, okay? They read every instructions line by line and generate machine code of that line and directly put into the main memory at some known address. First, see here, this is the structure of compile and go loader. Suppose this is your source program, okay? And compile and go translator. Here, there is no any particular loader will be work, okay? Here is assembler. Assembler is a translator and assembler also work as a loader. Means there is no specific loader, okay? Assembler, they work as a translator as well as work as a loader. So this is the concept of compile and go loader. So here assembler, which is also called as compile and go translator, they translate this source program and directly placed into the memory, right? And here in memory, assembler will be present. Assembler is work as a loader. Assembler execute one part of memory and data directly put into the memory location, right? Source program, assembler translate this source program into the object file and this object file directly placed into the memory. And that will be done by the assembler, which work as a loader. So after completion of assembly process, it assigns the starting address of program to the location counter. So here assembler work as a loader and they handle their memory address and location of that particular program. So it is also called as assemble and go, or we can say load and go system. And this loader generally used in Fortran language, and the loader name is VAT477. Okay, so this is the concept of compile and go loader, that is one kind of basic loader. Next, what are the advantages of compile and go loader? So compile and go loader is very easy to design and implementation, and relocation performed by the translator. Means here is no any separate loader. Assembler work as a translator and assembler work as a loader. Here no object file is created, right? Because translator convert the particular source program and directly placed into the memory. There is no object file will be created. So, and it is suitable for basic program. So these are the advantages of compile and go loader. Now what are the disadvantages? The disadvantages are wastage in memory space, because assembler placed into the main memory, right? So there is a wastage of memory space, because loaders required minimum memory as compared to assembler, right? Next, no production of object file. Object file is not generated. So source code is directly converted into the executable format. Hence, there is no modification in the source program. It's need to be assembled and executed each time. So there is a difficulty for changing a particular programs or modification in particular programs, because the object code is directly placed into the memory. And difficult to handle multiple linking modules. So these are the disadvantages of compile and go loader. Next. Okay. So next type of loader is general loader. So all the disadvantages of compile and go loader will be overcome into the general loader. So we know that first C language will be developed, then C++ language will be developed, then Java, right? So there is a particular sequence. All the features of C language, and there are again some additional features in C++ language. Again, there are some additional features in Java language, right? So it overcome or disadvantages of previous language. So similarly, general loader is a next loader after the compile and go loader. So in this loader scheme, source program is converted to object program by some translator. See here in this diagram, this is the structure of general loader scheme. Source program, here translator, and source program convert it into the object program. Okay, that's why translator is used. Source program is understood by the user, and object program which is understandable by the computer, right? So object program placed into the loader, loader fetch this object program and placed into the memory. In here, main memory loader will be present, right? In compile and go loader, there is assembler will be present. So loader accept this object modules and put into the machine instructions and data, right? In executable form, and assign the memory to that particular program. So loader occupies some portion in main memory. See here, source program translated into the object program, right? Then loader fetch this object program file and stored into the main memory for execution purpose, right? And size of loader is smaller than assembler. So this general loader generally used in some basic high level programming language. For example, C language, then Pascal language, Ruby language, right? So these are used in some basic high level language. Next, what are the advantages and disadvantages? Again, the advantages of general loader is reassembly of program is not needed. You don't need to any reassemble a particular program, right? Whatever the programs that will be present into the secondary memory, which will be directly stored into the main memory for execution purpose, right? Next, translator of source program, it produces compatible object program files. Then more memory is available to the user because loader is present into the main memory for execution purpose. And it also possible to write different subroutines and function. We can separately perform subroutines and functions to each and every programs. Now, these are the some disadvantages. Loader cannot handle different object module obtained from different kind of computers, right? Because general loader is used only for specific language, not other language we use this. And it can't perform multiple modules. It perform on some basic modules only, right? So these are the disadvantages. Again, disadvantages of general loader will be overcome into the next type of loader, right? So all next type of loaders we will learn in my next videos. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of general loader scheme. Next. So hope so you understood the concept of compile and go loader and general loader. In my next video, I will explain next types of loader. So keep watching. Thank you.